Welcome to this video on enhancing photos with text and graphics in PaintShop Pro. In this tutorial, you will learn how to add text to an image, importing a graphic onto an image, using a preset shape, adding a border, and changing layer opacity. PaintShop Pro has many useful tools that will allow you to add text, graphics, objects, and borders, which will turn an ordinary picture into a creative work of art. First, open PaintShop Pro and make sure that the Edit tab is active. Next, open the image that you will be using as your background. Text can be copied into PaintShop Pro from other programs. In this example, I have some text which is in a notepad file. Select all the text and then copy by using the key combination Control and the letter C on your keyboard. Select the text tool from the standard toolbar and click over the image around where the text will go. All the options for text in PaintShop Pro appear in the interactive properties bar at the top of your screen, including fonts, size, styles, and other common text properties. You can change these settings before or after placing your text. Use the key combination Control and the letter V on your keyboard to place the copied text. Color can be changed in the Materials palette. In this example, I will make the fill and the outline color the same by right-clicking and then left-clicking on the dark blue. To move the text, click the center of the text box using the Pick tool and drag the text into position. Next, I will create a title on the left. By highlighting only the top line, when you change the font size or other text properties, they will apply only to that part that has been highlighted. To arrange the text so that it lines up, you can create a guideline by dragging the mouse cursor down from the ruler at the top of the screen over the image. This line will not appear in the final saved image, nor will it be printed if you print your final project. Adding a graphic to an image is quite easy. Simply open the file containing the graphic and then from the Selections menu, choose Select All. Or you can use the key combination Control and the letter A on your keyboard. Next, copy the image using Control and the letter C. Or copy from the Edit menu. Click on the tab where your project is. From the Edit menu, select Paste as New Layer. By pasting the graphic as a new layer, you will be able to move it around and easily resize it at any time while working on your project. Next, let's frame the text box and make it stand out. To do this, click the Shape tool and select the rectangle. Draw a rectangle around the border of the text and the graphic. When you let go of the cursor, the rectangle will automatically create its own new layer. To round the edges, click on the Mode tool and then select a corner handle and pull along the line. With the rectangle selected, right-click in the Color Materials palette to change the fill. You can use the Width option in the Interactive Properties bar to increase the size of the border around the rectangle. Next, bring down the transparency of the layer to make the rectangle blend in with the background. Last but not least, the right border will be the crown and glory of the piece. From the Image menu, select Picture Frame. There are many picture frames to choose from, and in this example we will be using the cross-process frame. Make sure that you have selected to place the frame outside the image. That way, it will not cut off any of the picture or the text that you have created. After finishing a collage or a multi-layer project such as this, be sure to save as a PSP image file. That way, if you wish to return at a later time and make changes, your layers will remain intact. To create a version that can be sent to friends or shared online, go back to File, Save As, and choose JPEG. Whenever you save a multi-layer project as a JPEG, you will get a message warning, and this is to explain that a JPEG can only contain a single layer. Click OK to this message to continue. Thank you for watching this video on enhancing photos with text and graphics in PaintShop Pro. Thank you.